Hola, buenos días. Here we are again on another in the series, another video in the series of direct and indirect pronouns, or as we like to call them, the furniture removers list and the shoot at me list. Okay, so what I'd like to do is I'd like to talk about something that is so vitally important that if you don't know about it, it's going to cause you massive confusion, as it did me, okay? And what it is, well, there are two things, actually, I'm going to talk about. The first thing I'm going to talk about is this phenomenon. Leísmo, okay? And then I'm going to talk about this one. Okay, so what's this? Leísmo and laísmo. Okay, up to now I've been explaining the rules of how we use these pronouns, this metele, nosos, les, metelo, la, nosos, los, las, okay? So we know that the ones that have le in, they're the indirect ones, remember? There's something that comes in between. And then we know that the ones that have the lo and the la, the los and the las, well, they're the direct ones. And nothing comes between the actor and the person who's receiving the action. Okay, the doer and those who are done unto. Okay, so that's the rule. Except, would you believe that lots of people don't follow the rule? Okay, in Peninsular Spain, typically, okay, and I'm sure it'll happen in other regions as well, but in Peninsular Spain, in the center, in a very, very large area of the center, they do something very special with the pronouns, okay? So what they do, first of all, let's talk about leísmo. What is leísmo? Right, let me show you an example. Right, lo veo. Now, ver, to see somebody, is a direct verb, isn't it? Because you just look at them and see them. We mentioned this in the last video. Okay? So because of that, if we want to say I see him, we put a lo. Yeah? Lo veo. Nice and simple. However, if you are, and remember that the vast majority of Spain, a very, very large percentage of Spain, have this leísmo illness, okay? They are what are called leístas, okay? And what that means is that they use le when they shouldn't. So somebody from the center, and remember this is the capital, Madrid in Spain, okay? Lots and lots of literature, news, so much comes from the capital. And in the capital, they are leístas, okay? So, what somebody from Madrid, for example, would say, they wouldn't say lo veo, they would say le veo, okay? And that would be, I see him, okay? Why do they do that? Well, the reason that they do that, they only do this, they only replace the lo with the le when they're talking about some person, a person. This is not a thing, you see? And so somebody from Madrid would say to you, yeah, but if you say lo veo, we don't know if you're talking about an it or a him. We don't know if you're talking about a person or an inanimate object, okay? So what they do in the center of Spain is that they use le whenever they are talking about a him, okay? And they'll use les veo, if they're saying, I see them, okay? Obviously, it should be los veo, okay? But in the center of Spain, they will replace the lo for the le, and they'll replace the los for the les, okay? This is for, the whole point of leísmo is for clarity, so that you know that the person is talking about a person. another thing. That's what it's about, okay? So if that weren't enough, then we have laísmo, okay? Because people from the center of Spain are also laístas. And what does that mean? Well, it's the same thing. That means that they use la when they should use le. Now, let me explain. So, a laísta does this. When should you use a le? Well, you should use a le when you're using an indirect verb, and the le can be to him or to her, okay? Or to it. So let's say, okay, so here we are. Le mando algo, I send, and in this case, we're going to say it's her, okay? Maria, I send her something. Now, true Spanish, the correct Spanish, is that that le can refer to a him or a her, okay? Le mando algo a Jorge, le mando algo a María, okay? So, that's what it should be. However, if you are a laísta, if you come from this big part of Spain in the middle, what you would do is this. If this was a woman, you would say, la mando algo. Now, officially it's not correct. It should be le. But why does laísmo exist? It exists because when you use le and without a name, we don't know whether it's a him or a her. Okay, we don't know. Le mando algo. You would have to say a quién, who, to whom are you sending, yeah? So what they do, the laístas, is they use la instead of le for clarity so that we know that we're talking about a woman, okay? It should be le, but they use la. The same as if we were saying, I send them, and them would be all women, they wouldn't say les, they would say las. Las mando. Las mando algo. I send them to those women something, okay? So it's for clarity that it exists to identify gender. This is why they're doing it, okay? Because les doesn't identify gender, does it? Okay, right. But let me show you something that just makes it a little bit more complex, okay? Because remember that the whole point of laísmo is to identify gender, the same as laísmo, it's to identify gender. So, look at this sentence. Le mando a María la carta. Okay, now, in this sentence, it's clear that María is having some, that the recipient is María. It's clear, okay? So a laísta won't change that to la. They don't need to, because it's clear that it's María, okay? So that's the little, that makes it just a little bit more complex, is that if the gender is clear, then they will follow the rule. They will say le, okay? But if we just say, le mando la carta, and it's María, then they would put in la, to show that it's a woman that's being sent this letter, yeah? So that's the two options, la mando la carta, or le mando la carta a María, okay? Notice I'm mixing around the structure, but you can, okay. So, can you see what's happening here? What you've got is this laísmo, which is all about making sure that we know that when we use le, we're talking about a man, Okay? So, let me give you some examples. If I'm calling somebody, okay, that's direct. That's just a direct thing. I'm not giving them anything, okay? So it should be, lo llamo. Lo llamo, okay? Lo llamo. And if I was calling a woman, I would say, la llamo. But a leísta would say, le llamo, for a man. Le llamo. And for a woman, they would say, la llamo. So they wouldn't be wrong with the la, because that's what they do anyway. Yeah? But it would be more correct to say lo llamo and not le, but you're going to hear people saying le llamo. So everything that I've told you about how to identify a direct and an indirect verb goes out the window with leísmo and laísmo. It goes out the window. So this is where the confusion comes in, and this is where my confusion came, because I kind of came back from Mexico with the idea of how this worked. Okay, more or less. And then Cynthia would say, it's not lo, it's le. And I'd be like, wait a minute, why is it le? Surely it should be lo. That's what I've heard for the last 2 years, lo, lo, lo. No, no, le. Okay? So when I investigated it, this is what came up, this leísmo, laísmo. It isn't talked about massively, but it's in lots of literature. I'm reading a book with my students called El Camino. It's by Miguel Delibes. Beautiful book. El Camino by Miguel Delibes. I recommend it if once you're at a certain level, okay? But he's from Madrid. And so when he writes, he's a leísta. So all of his literature is written like that. Or, well, certainly the book I'm reading. So that can cause massive confusion, because it's going against the rules. But as long as you understand it, then you can start to at least put it into its place. What happens? The truth is, I am a leísta and I am a laísta. Okay, the same as Cynthia is, because Cynthia's from Madrid and I've spent the last 10 years with Cynthia learning from her and learning from her family. I am now working jolly hard on putting that right, or putting that into a better way, okay? It isn't that it's wrong, because understand that in the whole of the Spanish-speaking world, every place has its variations. Every place. Just look at English and how many variations we have. There is no right nor wrong. I mean, obviously there's certain levels of Spanish that would be just wrong. But all of these regional eccentricities are not wrong. And leísmo and laísmo is accepted by the academy, the Spanish academy, as a correct way of speaking for that region. So what you have to do is, when you go to if you're going to spend time in a particular place, all you do is listen to how they use their Spanish, and then you can copy that if you want. But if you don't, if you say, right, certainly I'm not going to be a leísta and a laísta, and I'm going to do these correctly, that's perfect. You would be understood wherever you go, because that's standard Spanish, okay? All that people would know is that when you were speaking Spanish, that you hadn't learned the Spanish from that region, okay? So, leísmo, just to review, what have I told you? Leísmo is where people use le when they should use lo, okay? And le is just the standard when you want to say him, to him, for him, at him, le. Okay? And les for at them, for them, on them, to them. That's what they do. They just use as a blanket pronoun. And then the la is used in place of le when it's not sure that it's a woman, when you haven't mentioned the name. So just for clarity, they use la to make sure that you know that they're talking about a woman. It should be le, but they use la. And also it should be les, and they'll use las if they're talking about a group of feminine things. Okay? So As I said to you at the beginning, it's not sure that you'll take everything in that I've just told you. But what I'd like you to do is this. I'd like you to obviously think about what I've told you. And as you're looking through your material, okay, you're looking through books or anything, or you're listening to somebody, see if you can hear them and see if you can find out if they are a laista or a leista. Listen to how they're using their indirect pronouns. Listen to the indirect verbs, the indirect ones, and see if they're using a la, okay? And listen to when they're using the direct verbs and see if they're using a lo, when they should be using a le, and you'll spot it, okay? Okay, so that's your challenge, to see if you can spot the leistas and the laistas, and spot the ones who aren't, spot the ones who are using it correctly. Okay, pues nos vemos, y nos vemos en el próximo video. Voy a hablar de cómo funcionan los pronombres, how the pronouns work, a little bit more. Okay, hasta luego.